Welcome, Thursday's edition of Daddy's Kitchen.
This is how we're doing up in here.
The day before the CrossFit game semifinal, Christian Harris preps his breakfast. He swipes that apron. This guy means business. Listen. He's not just serious on the comp floor, but he's just as serious in the kitchen.
That's
listen,
great.
I don't mess around.
Wait, where did it come from?
It was in the drawer. It's perfect.
It is.
He wears one at home.
I know.
You got one of those at home?
You gotta wear that on the grill.
I'm not the best chef in the kitchen.
Egg whites or
Brit? 500 followers plus after yesterday, right?
Just, no, after the time of just, joining the
just
team.
Just gaining popularity.
I'm trying.
Influencer.
We're working on it.
How do you feel about this?
I mean, it was kind of sad because they didn't do it to anybody else, so it's pretty simple.
Are they going to mail you, a new shirt?
I think they're going to try to get it back to us this weekend, because all they have to do is print on it, but they could mail it to us.
They could do that.
Do you think
customer service, you know?
Do they have a screen printing shop in the back behind that door right there? No.
They definitely do not.
Did a quick touch on tomorrow, but we're gonna touch on this a little bit more tomorrow since we know we have a lot more time.
Today.
Legless rope climbs. You and Katie are gonna do the same routine of 2-1-2-1, but once Chris and Britt come back from the run, Chris is gonna start with two quick legless rope climbs, and then they're gonna cycle through as singles. And it's gonna go Chris, Britt, you, Katie, as singles in rope climbs. So once they get back, there's no more doubles for you.
So, influencer.
Yes.
How are you going to influence the team in day one?
I'm just going to feed off Chris H. over here.
Oh, okay.
C? Oh my God, I can't even talk.
Chris H.? Is that what she said?
All right, Chris H.
I want to say CH and then Chris.
Like an elementary school.
We got too many names here.
Well,
too many
the
names.
Thing of,
Chris H.
I like that.
Chris H. What's Chris the H. answer? Get us a little off him.
We know what kind of influencer you are. There's the kind of influencer that likes to talk on their Instagram, and then there's the kind that's just like just photos.
Just tag me and I'll repost.
I'm assuming that's the kind of influencer you are.
You don't, which one do you think I am?
You don't like to use words, you know?
I don't.
You fumble over Chris H. and all that stuff.
Yeah, I tend to have to read.
You're a doer. You're a doer.
Not a talker.
That's right.
Because then I just talk too much, you know?
That's
and
right.
And the words start to twist and turn the wrong way.
You just walk the walk. You leave
the
talk out of it.
Yep.
What are you going to do today that's going to be so fire on day one that all the boys are going to DM you?
Oh, my God.
Come on. What are you going to do?
What am I going to do? I'm gonna show everyone my snatch.
Oh, okay. Alright. Hometown hero, Will Carter.
What's
day
up?
One, what are you looking forward to most today?
I'm looking forward to just getting started. I just wanna get going. I just wanna start warming up.
Got
just
you.
Just need to get going.
You've put in the work and
that's
now
right. We just need to go.
You're ready
rip
to
off
let
that band-aid.
That's right.
Get that first workout in, just like get that first hit in, then you're good to go for the rest of the game.
Let the work work.
That's where I'm at, yeah.
Daddy Chef.
Daddy Chef.
All right, day one. What are you going to cook up today for us, Chef Daddy?
Well, we got this briefing right now. Pretty hungry. I got a bag full of sandwiches. So that's about to go down.
All right, so you're a good Chef Daddy, always feeding the kids.
Well, I didn't prepare the sandwiches. This was from the kids.
Oh, the kids? Okay, yeah. Okay. Got the kids up early, said make your sandwiches before the bus takes off.
That's it.
There we go down to 280. You're making calls right now. 265 feels like you're there. From what I'm seeing from here, you should be looking around. 280 to 285 would be the top top end hit. But I'll be right in front of you, that's all you know. So keep it up. I don't see anybody in here. Then we switch. You can help Will know. Will, you're gonna start with 295. Then we're gonna go 335-ish, and then you go from there based off how you feel. At that point, girls, you're gonna come off with your bar. 170, 175, okay? You're great, you're over that 190, right? Okay. After that, we go to sprint. Make sure you guys have your shit changed. Will, Katie, Britt, Chris. Let's get this push workout done. Matt, motherfucker, you guys know what you have to do. It's time to show up. Move fast on three. One, two, three, move fast! Let's go, let's go! Great job.
We had to run across the field.
What are we after?
I don't know yet. All it has in here right now.
Will Carter, 335 clean and jerk. And then hit 380 with a clean off his knee.
370.
Oh, it's 370. Stood up 370 from a dead stop off of his knee like a savage.
You're asking me when I have 2 more minutes to be sad about it, so I'm pretty pissed right now about it.
Yeah, you have 2 more minutes.
I think after 2 more minutes, I'm not going to be mad about it. But, you know, the butt clean felt really good. I was just a little forward, and my knee dropped, so freaking sucks. I feel like I was confident I could get it. But that's how the game goes. You know, you shoot your shot. This is what it is, you know. One more minute and I'm gonna move on. But right now I'm freaking pissed. But it is what it is. You know, gotta move on from it.
Well, you turned it around in event 3 on the Devil Walk, so it's just the beginning, baby.
It's just the beginning. All right. Gotta get after it.
I was feeling real good on the Devil's Press.
So Britt Morella putting up some big poundage in event 1.
I was proud of it. I was a little nervous waiting 40 minutes.
Right, that first lift was like nothing.
I know, I should have went a little heavier.
You're at 190, right?
Yeah, 190.
Uh-huh.
And then I went 205.
Yep.
And I was going to go, that's a good picture.
That's a good picture, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
And then I was going to go 220, but I wanted to be safe.
You snatched it. I feel like there was.
So if I missed if I missed 220, my score would have been 205, and I know we would have wanted a little higher points on that because the sprint was coming.
All right, so everyone that's watching, that's a CrossFitter. Your jerks were super snappy. What kind of jerk cues could you give like us newbies out here to get those fast, nice, clean elbows you got
on the clean?
On the jerk. Like your lockout was just like
punch the ceiling. That's my biggest cue. Punch that ceiling.
All right.
I love a good jerk.
You love a good jerk. All right. Got the cheerleader over here, Friggy. All right, Friggy. It was an eventful day 1 for you.
It was.
You hit that 175 snatch after missing your first lift.
Yep.
Now, what were you thinking? You missed the first lift. How do you overcome that and then have a good performance on lift 2 and 3?
So, after I failed my first snatch, I knew that mind is everything and I had to just let it go. It felt pretty good, honestly. It was like over my head, so I was like, all right. It wasn't like it was like too heavy or not enough power, so I was like, all right, I got this. So, you know, just went in positive, clean slate for the second lift, hit it, then went 125.
I gotta be honest, you actually make me nervous when you snatch, because when you caught lift 2 and 3, instead of like
keeping that straight face and standing, you would smile. Oh, and I'm like, yo, don't smile, girl. Just stand that thing up.
Because I know.
Don't fool around.
If I sit in the bottom, and I'm like, all right, I got this. And then I'll stand up.
Yeah,
it's my thing. It was. Like, I know.
It was half nerve-wracking, half enjoyable to watch. So.
Gotta keep you guys on your toes, you know.
Good job on that.
Thank you.
Good luck in day 2 and 3.
Thanks.
Got the chef getting some work done over here. Made our rounds. Interviewed the other 3 team members post day 1. Little snap crackle pop there. Christian Harris puts up 280 on the snatch. Missed it on a second attempt. That third one was super clean. So what would you have put up on that third lift? What was the third number you had in mind?
295.
Yeah, you had that shiz.
Overpulled on that 280.
I know it. There's a bit of me inside that was like, just go up anyways.
Yeah.
Were you thinking that?
I was trying to make the veteran smart decision.
Yeah, smart decision. Uh-huh.
Old me would
not
have,
ego
would have
decision.
Old me would have definitely gone up.
100.
Right, because 280 was still one of the best lifts on the floor, and you guys got second place for the men in that.
Yeah.
So as the team captain.
This is new me.
New you. All right, new you. Team
Christian
captain.
4.0?
I don't know what we're at now.
All right, so day 2 as the captain, what are you looking to mindset for the team? What are you looking to keep everyone focused on?
I think just not worrying about what happened already. Whatever happened is already done. I think all we can do now is focus on the next workout at hand. And really, we had a lot of missed execution for today. So I think if we execute, we'll be in a much better spot, you know?
Thumbs up.
You're unofficially at third. We'll see if the leaderboard shakes out any differently, but that's gotta feel good to feel like you didn't give your best and yet you're still sitting pretty good, so. Good luck in day 2 and 3.